In this video, I'll be showing you how to make a Bitmoji classroom in 2021. I know that a lot of teachers are making Bitmoji scenes almost entirely from scratch in Google Slides or PowerPoint, so I want to just show you a more efficient, effective way that you can make a Bitmoji scene for your classroom. My name is Sam Kary, and this is my YouTube channel for the new EdTech classroom. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a Bitmoji scene in Canva. And you can get a free Canva account by going to canva.com/education. And there you can register for a free educator account, which is essentially like getting Canva Pro for free. And that will also get your students an account. And there are all kinds of awesome creativity projects that they can do too. Now, once you're in Canva, you're going to want to go up to the search box and type Bitmoji. There you'll see that there are a bunch of different pre-created Bitmoji scenes for you to choose from. You'll also notice that there's this blank one here, so if you wanted to start totally from scratch, you could do that too. So to check out a template, what I'm going to do is just click on it, and then once I'm inside of the template, you'll see that all of the elements in the template are going to be fully editable. So for example, you can click on the text and type your own instead. And of course, you can also change the font type and the size and make the font look however you want it to look. Now up here, if rather than books to read, you wanted to change this to include your image or maybe the image of a student for student of the month, you can do that too. All you need to do is upload the original image or a screenshot of an image to Canva. To do that, go to Uploads and then click Upload Media. There you'll be able to search for different images from your device, and I'll just bring one in of myself here as an example. Then click the text in the box where you want to put that image and delete it so that it creates some space. Now just select the image that you uploaded and drag it where you want it to go. You'll also see that you need to just drag the sides of the image to make it fit in the space that you want it to fit. Now, let's say that you like this chair, but you don't really like the color of it. If you want to change the color, you just need to click on it, and then you'll see that a menu will pop up on the top of the screen, and that's actually going to allow you to change all of the different colors in the chair. So you can see that you can customize the color of the legs of the chair, the cushion, and of course the chair itself. And then if you want to move the chair around, you can just click on it and drag it where you want it to go. Every single element in the template is also fully editable. So again, you might like the bookshelf, but not really care for this flower pot on top of it. All you need to do is click on the flower pot and then delete it. The same goes for the other elements on the bookshelf, as well as other objects in the room and different geometric shapes that are decorating the Bitmoji scene here. Of course, you could also just change the color of each of these objects if you didn't want to delete them. Another option would be to drag the objects around and change their location. So you can see that just by deleting some of the objects, by changing the font types and changing colors of other objects, as well as the floor of the room, you can totally customize the way that this Bitmoji scene looks. Now, to take this customization a little bit farther, you can also do things like swap out the objects for different ones. These could be images that you upload to Canva, like the picture that I brought in of myself, or you can search for images that already have transparent backgrounds directly in Canva by going to the Elements tab. So here, for example, I'll type flower pot, and I'll just swap out this flower pot with a different one. I'll change out the clock to make it look more like the old clock in my classroom. And then I'm also going to change this lamp to make it a little bit more of a modern version. Then I'm even going to add a different desk here and then delete the old one. And then I'll size that desk down and replace the objects on top of it. So now you can see I have a whole brand new setup. Okay, now that you've customized the scene exactly how you want, it's time to bring in your Bitmoji. Canva has a direct integration with Bitmoji, and you can see that I already have it installed here because you can see the Bitmoji logo show up. If you don't already have Bitmoji integrated with Canva, you can easily do that by clicking on the three dots on the menu and then signing into your Bitmoji account. Now, this is going to require that you sign in through Snapchat. So if you don't have a Snapchat account, you can just create one in order to be able to sign in. But if you don't want to sign into Snapchat, then the other way to do this is to just open up Bitmoji as a Chrome extension. And then you'd want to drag the Bitmoji that you're looking for onto your computer desktop. and then re-upload that as an image. Either way will work. Okay, so let's say that you use the Bitmoji integration, just like you would with the extension. You're just going to search for whatever it is that you're looking for. So for example, you might search for sitting here. And then of course, you can also just scroll through the different Bitmojis to see what shows up. Now, one trick that I learned from Holly Clark in a TikTok video that she put up is that if you search for pose, that's only going to show Bitmoji images that don't have text. So this is obviously going to be useful for something like a Bitmoji scene here. Then once I find one I like, just like I did with an image, I'll just drag and drop it in and resize it however I need to. Now notice how right now the Bitmoji is in front of the desk, but if I wanted it to be behind the desk, it's really easy to do that with changing the image layers in Canva. Here I'm just going to click on the Bitmoji and then I'll click send back. When I send it back, you'll see that the Bitmoji is now behind the desk, but the computer is still in front. So what I'll have to do here is just move my Bitmoji over to the side a little bit and then click on the computer, move the computer to the front, and then my Bitmoji will be behind the desk and the computer. Of course, I can do this to put myself behind other objects as well. So I'll put myself behind the chair, and now you'll notice that the clock is in front of me. So I'm just gonna send the clock back so that it looks more natural and a little bit more realistic. Now, if you really want to take this Bitmoji scene to the next level, you could do something really fun, like bring in an animated GIF of yourself that has the background removed. Now, I explain how to make these using a program called Unscreen in another video that I'll put in the video description. So I'm not going to show you how to make it in this video, but you can see that once I upload this GIF to Canva, just like any other piece of media, I can just drag my animated GIF into the Bitmoji scene, resize it around, and now you'll see that there's actually an animated GIF of me waving to my students. So again, this is just something you could do to add a little bit of fun factor to your Bitmoji scenes. By the way, you can also just drop these animated GIFs on a Google Slides without going through the process of making a Bitmoji scene if you were interested in doing that. Let's just go back here to our regular Bitmoji scene though. And what I wanna do is download it so that I can re-upload it into a Google Slides as the background. So what I'll do here is just go up to the top, I'll go to download, and then I'm going to choose to download this as an image. Then you can hop over to a Google Slides presentation or PowerPoint, and here in Google Slides, I'll click change background, and then I'm going to select that Bitmoji scene that I just created, and then I'll just delete the text boxes that are on top of it so that my Bitmoji scene shows up cleanly on my Google Slides. That's it. Now I have a fully customized Bitmoji scene, and I didn't have to worry about going out and finding transparent images or really even doing a ton of work on my own because Canva has such awesome pre-created templates that I could just build from. Now back over here in Canva for a moment, just remember that there are also all these other templates that you could try out, and these are also, of course, fully customizable. And then there is this blank one here too. So if you wanted to build one totally from the ground up, you could do that as well. If you appreciated the tips I shared in this video, then be sure to hit the like button and share it with other teachers that you know. You can also check out more videos that I have on my channel about teaching with Canva for education by clicking on that playlist above. And if you're just getting started using education technology in your classroom or looking to take a more strategic approach, then I invite you to check out my free How to Teach with Technology starter kit. You can get it at my website at newedtechclassroom.com/starterkit. It's a mini online course that's going to teach you how to choose the right EdTech tools, how to teach students how to use those tools, and so much more. Plus, it includes lots of downloadable resources that you can take and use in your classroom. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next video.